A Baguio court issues a temporary restraining order and writ of Amparo ordering Cordillera police to cease publishing materials branding individuals and organizations as communist terrorists. Meanwhile, at the Supreme Court, an associate justice considering early retirement due to health reasons. Mike Navalia joins us now with the details. Mike, go ahead.
Hi, Carmina. A Baguio City Court has ordered the Cordillera police to stop red-tagging youth activists and their organizations. In an order dated March 24, Baguio City Regional Trial Court Branch 3 Judge Emmanuel Cacho Rasing granted the plea for a temporary restraining order filed by four youth leaders, ordering the Cordillera PNP to refrain during the pendency of the case from making any publication in social media or otherwise which red-tags petitioners. In a separate order on March 25, Rasing also issued a writ of amparo requiring the Cordillera PNP to explain within 5 days its lawful defenses to show that it did not violate or threaten with violation the right to life, liberty, and security. The writ of amparo petition was filed by four youth activists who said that they were red-tagged by the police through social media posts and tarpaulins after they actively took part in rallies and protest actions. President Rodrigo Duterte in 2017 has declared the CPP-NPA as terror groups, while the newly formed Anti-Terrorism Council followed suit in December last year. These leaders said that while some of the Facebook posts were made by fictitious accounts, some were made by clearly police accounts and shared by accounts of other PNP entities. Some of the posts contained false quotes attributed to them, while a video directly named one of the petitioners as a CPP-NPA recruiter in Baguio City. The photos of all four youth leaders were also plastered in tarpaulins placed in different locations within Baguio City and Benguet. And in one instance, the photo of one of the petitioners during a roundtable discussion with government forces was used in a tarpaulin hung during a public gathering of a Philippine Army Infantry Division in Cagayan Valley last year. The youth leaders said they received threatening messages as a result of the red tagging. In their petition, they said the posts in the tarpaulins contained malicious imputations of the crime of terrorism and exposed them to real and imminent danger. They said that the circulation of these materials among the local PNP network create in the minds of law enforcement people that they are indeed enemies of the state who deserve to be eliminated. The quantity and frequency of the posts, they said, shows that these are not isolated occurrences, but a systematic effort to red tag the petitioners. They sought a 20-day TRO and asked the Police Regional Office Cordillera and Police Brigadier General Arwin Pagkalinawan, the regional director, who were both named as respondents, be ordered to take down the social media posts and other forms of publicity. The court granted an indefinite TRO, but said the request to take down the posts will be dealt with during the course of the hearings. Reacting to the ruling, NUPL President Enzo Olalia says, "We are now seeing a gradual but flowing stream of positive results of our pushback. Hopefully," he said, "this will help turn the tide of impunity soon. Ultimately, anything bad never lasts." The Baguio court ruling comes as Senate Minority Leader Francine Drilon filed a bill Thursday seeking a 10-year imprisonment for any state agent convicted of red tagging. Various groups have welcomed that filing of a bill. Meanwhile, in other news, a Supreme Court Associate Justice is considering retiring early due to health reasons. Supreme Court spokesperson Brian Kit Hosaka confirmed that Associate Justice Edgardo de los Santos said that due to health reasons, he is considering retiring ahead of his mandatory retiring age of 70. This was based on a letter of March 19, which circulated yesterday, where de los Santos informed his staff that he is retiring early and advised them to look for jobs. Hosaka said that de los Santos confirmed this, saying that he advised his staff to look for other employment, knowing the difficulty of finding a job during the pandemic. But Hosaka clarified that de los Santos remains an incumbent member of the Supreme Court until after a specific date of retirement, as may be indicated in a formal letter to the Supreme Court on bank, if accepted and acted upon by the Supreme Court. Carmina?
Thanks a lot. Mike Navalia there joining us on the line. Mike, keep safe.